Hello, my name is Greg O'Connor. I'm a PhD candidate in the lab of Dr. Sylvia Daunert, and my research focuses on using bacterial communication and their molecules that they produce to better understand how the bacteria in your gut actually communicate with the rest of your body. The focus of my research in the lab actually started on IBD, which is inflammatory bowel disease. It's a very debilitating condition where you actually have the problem where your own body's immune system attacks your gut. So it's one of these diseases that we don't fully understand it because you've got the bacteria in your gut, genetics, and a lot of different factors, including environmental, that come into play. So we're trying to go ahead and figure out a way, what can we do to better understand this disease so we can then look at better therapeutics and management for people who have the disease. What I really like about working in the lab is actually a little bit beyond just the lab setting, and it's working with the people. For me, I've always been a bit more social. I've enjoyed getting out with people, you know, getting to know new people and having a good time. And so through working in a lab, I've worked a lot with undergraduates, other graduate students, different faculty, people that I normally wouldn't talk to, and now I get to see them on a daily basis. I was born here in the United States in northern New Jersey, up in the mountain region near the New York border. A little bit of a middle of nowhere small town that thankfully now there's actually a highway that bypasses it so you can get to it. But before, it took you about 4 or 5 hours driving through the mountains to get to it. I had originally considered either being an MD medical doctor or even a pharmacist. And before that, it was looking more, I also looked into NASA and engineering. For me, a lot of it kind of tied into science, which really ties back to in middle school, I had a fantastic science teacher. She had worked as an engineer, and her focus was on doing the experiments and making it fun. When it came down to actually going into medical research, probably one of the most difficult things for me was developing the technical skills. Usually you go by the rules of three. You want to repeat an experiment at least 3 times to verify your results, because if you're not consistently seeing the same thing every time, it's highly likely that you made a mistake. And science really forces you to be humble, because the vast majority of research is failures. One of the most fascinating parts of my research, it's actually the material that I work with, and I work a lot with stool samples. So it's kind of a fantastic sample that allows you to do so much. It all comes down to just learning to deal with it and sometimes plugging your nose up.
Okay, so in order for us to quantify the concentration of bacteria,
truly a goal that I would hope to achieve, that we're working towards it and hopefully it will be there sooner versus later, is to try and use bacterial communication as the next way to stop the bacteria. We could cut that communication, we could stop the bad bacteria from attacking you, and that would allow us to hopefully better control the disorder. For anyone that's interested in science and is thinking about research, go out and try it. Go in and get a real feeling over a couple weeks or a couple months, what is it like to do research? Because that's going to give you the best bet. And even if it's something that you're thinking, I'm not going to like that, like I initially did not think I would ever enjoy working with fecal samples, it's something that I've realized the value in. Or if nothing else, I could have realized, I don't like this.